Hello creators, my name is Anne and today I will show you how I quickly texture clothing from Cloth3D and Marvelous Designer in Blender. In the previous video, we were exporting this dress from Cloth3D. We created a UV map, baked normal map for seam lines, exported and imported it to Blender, and connected seam lines normal map to materials. Watch this video if you missed it, link in the top right corner. Now I'm gonna show you how I set up PBR textures for silk and lace materials. I will add diffuse and ambient occlusion maps, roughness, metallic, normal, and opacity maps. These textures are free, you can find them by following the link in the description. We are in a Blender 3.0 right now. Let's go to the shading tab. I will set up a workspace so you can see the full dress on the left and the node tree on the right. Then I switch to the render view mode. I'm going to render the final image on cycles, that's why I turn on cycles in the render properties. Because I exported this dress from Cloth3D, I already have all the materials assigned. I will start with the silk fabric first. This is a principal BSDF shader to which we will connect all the textures. It's a normal map for seam lines that we baked and added in the previous video. It creates small bumps on the seam's location. That's how it looks if I unplug it. Seams are not visible anymore. I will start with adding a first texture, diffuse map. Press Shift A and search for the image texture. Then click on the Open Image button and select the diffuse map. Sometimes it can be called base color or albedo. Connect color output to the base color input and you will see this texture on the dress. In my case, this texture doesn't have any noticeable pattern, so I can actually ignore it, unplug it and choose the color manually by clicking on this color icon. I'd like to make it blue. The second map is roughness. Select the first image texture node and press Shift D to duplicate it. Then open a roughness map and connect it to the roughness input. Very important to change color space to non-color. It should be set to non-color for all maps except for the diffuse map. Do the same with the metallic. Duplicate the node and open a metallic texture, this one. Change the color space and plug it into metallic input. This map isn't very popular for fabrics, but we need it to achieve a silky looking material. The last texture is a normal map. Open it and check the color space again. Now we need to combine these two normal maps. I usually add Mix RGB node for this. Shift A and search Mix RGB. Then place it between image texture and normal map nodes and connect this color output to color 2 input. Then change the blending mode to overlay. Now you can control the intensity of the color 2 input with a factor value. At the moment we have a fabric texture plugged into this input. So if you set the factor to 1, this node will use 100% of the fabric texture. If you set it to 0, it won't use this texture at all. It's better to check it on the preview of each node. Make sure that you turned on Node Wrangler add-on. If not, go to the Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, type Node Wrangler and activate it. Now when you press Ctrl Shift left mouse button on the fabric texture node, you will see how it looks before any other nodes are applied. If you Ctrl Shift left click on Mix RGB node, you will see the blending of these two normal maps. And now when factor isn't set to 1, you can notice that fabric texture looks less intensive than on the original texture. However, the intensity of seams doesn't change. I prefer to control the intensity of seam lines rather than texture, so I swap the inputs. And now I can adjust the intensity of seams. Great, I will set it to 0.5 for now and get back to it a little bit later. Ctrl Shift left click on the BSDF shader and we see all the textures applied. It doesn't look like silk though. First of all, the scale is huge. We can control it with a mapping node. Select one of the image texture nodes and press Ctrl T. Then plug vector output to vector inputs of all fabric textures. Do not apply it to the seam lines, it has its own specific scale. Now you can increase the scale. Click and hold on top value and drag down, then right to quickly change the value. Here we go. The next step is to adjust the roughness map intensity, so it won't be so glossy. I will add the math node. Shift A, math, and place it between texture and shader. It became less glossy, but it's too much. You can control this value to adjust it. Zero value doesn't change the texture at all, so I need to set it somewhere between 0 and 0.5. 0.3 looks good. When all the textures are plugged in, I will update some settings a bit. I will make the color more saturated. And adjust seam lines intensity. I'd like to make them less visible. Also, you can control the overall intensity of normal maps with this strength value. And that's it for the silk. Let's move on with the lace. As always, I start with adding an image texture node. The same story as with the silk. This diffuse map doesn't have a pattern, so I will ignore it and add roughness. Change the color space and connect it. Then let's add the normal map. Change color space to non-color and combine these two normal maps as we did for the silk material. Add mix RGB node, connect all color inputs and outputs, and change the blending mode to overlay. You can already see that the scale is too big, so let's add a mapping node. Ctrl T and connect it to the roughness texture. Change the scale. Then I will add the mask texture or opacity. This one. Change color space and connect it to the alpha input and to the mapping node. Now it looks like lace. Finally, I have an ambient occlusion map and I'm going to use it to add some shadows to my lace. Make it more volumetric. You can notice that the lace looks a little bit flat at the moment. I will open the AO map. It looks like a black and white texture. This black contour will help us to add some shadows. I will connect it to the base color input and to my mapping node. Now I need to add a color to it. Add mix RGB node, place it between nodes, change the blending mode to multiply, and change the color too. I will make it pink. As with the mix RGB node for normal maps, we can control color to input with the factor value. So I set it to 1 to see 100% of the pink color. Now if you preview the ambient occlusion map, you will see that it was black and white, and then we added a pink color to it. Now I want to amplify this black contour, make it more noticeable. For this, I add a color ramp node and place it between these two nodes. Take this left handle and move it to the right. Now when you switch to the BSDF shader, you can notice that flowers become more volumetric. This is how it looked without the AO map. Okay, I need to set the same color on the BSDF shader to show you the difference. So this is how it looks without ambient occlusion. And this is with, a little bit more realistic. And that's it for the lace. I also have two materials for top stitches, single line and Bartek. I exported them as a mesh from Cloth3D. The process of texturing will be the same as for silk and lace, so I will not focus on it right now. I hope this video was useful for you. If you have any ideas on how to improve PBR texturing, let me know in the comments. And see you in the next videos. Bye!